Well, dear students, let's continue the NEET of Human Health and Diseases, the last session of this chapter. Question number 178. What is shown in the figure here? Diagram they have shown. They have shown a leaf of a tree. You all know that that's a leaf of a cannabis sativum. Fine. So wherein from which cannabinoids are obtained. So he is asking what is the shown in the figure? Option A, opium, B, datura, C, cannabis, and D, tobacco. It can't be tobacco leaf. So it is cannabis. C is the correct answer over here. Fine. Next, cannabinoids are mainly known to affect, fine, A, cardiovascular system, B, nervous system, C, sensory system, and D, excretory system. Cannabinoids are mainly known to affect cardiovascular system, that is the blood supply and blood circulation system, and they also affect the heartbeat, heart rate, thereby. So option A is the correct answer, that is cardio vascular system. Next one, chorus, ganja, hashish, and marijuana are all. What are these? One is chorus, ganja, hashish, and marijuana are all are what they are asking. Fine. One is A, opioids, B, cannabinoids, C, coca alkaloids, and D, barbiturates. They all obtained from, fine, cannabinoids. They obtained from the plant cannabis sativum. Fine. First is chorus obtained. They have given in the order. Clear. So all are cannabinoids with that affect the cardiovascular system of human being. Next one, very easy question. Cocaine is obtained from A, erythroxylum coca. He has given the source here. Plant names here. Cocaine is a which is a steroidal drug is obtained from erythroxylum coca. B, papaver somnifera. C, atropa belladonna, and D, cornealis sativa. Option A, you all know that cocaine is obtained from erythroxylum coca. Clear? Fine. So this is the answer, option C. Moving on to next question. Coca plant is a native of which country is asking? Coca plant, which also added into chocolates, I have told you. Fine. Coconuts, coca. Coca plant is that makes you to become addicted to that. Many points I have told. So coca plant is a native of A, North America, B, South America, C, South Africa, and D, Australia. Fine. It belongs to South America. So B option is the correct answer over there. Next question. Cocaine is commonly known as A, smack, no, B, coke, C, crack. Fine. So it is both B and C, thereby option D is the correct answer, both B and C. Cocaine is also known as coke and also crack. Next, cocaine produces a sense of dash. Sense of dash, this word I have told you, euphoria. Fine. It's nothing but, fine, a sense of what we call hangover. In common language we call hangover. Fine. You feel like in a different world. So hallucinational world, such things are known as euphoria. Euphoria. So cocaine produces a sense of euphoria. B, A, euphoria. B, dysphoria. C, depression, and D, androgenic effects. Fine. Neither it causes dysphoria nor depression. It's not a sedative, and androgenic effects are also not seen in certain organs. So euphoria, fine, is the correct answer, wherein you feel like imaginary world or hallucination world. Fine. Next one, excessive dosage of cocaine causes, clear, A, cardiovascular collapse, that is the malfunctioning or the stoppage of the cardiovascular system. What do you mean by cardiovascular collapse means? B, hallucinations, C, nerve damage, and D, vomiting. Clear? So hallucinations, B is the correct answer. Excessive dosage of cocaine causes hallucination. What do you mean by hallucination? Something beyond the imaginary world, something which is not possible, and you feel like you can do it. Fine. Like for example, like Superman works, no? So wherein you can feel like you can do it. For example, like you feel like you can fly in air, or you can feel like you can lift the whole car. Fine. So this impractical or almost impossible work which you feel you can do it, such things are known as hallucinations. Fine. Okay. Next one, atropa belladonna is, fine, atropa belladonna is ornamental plant. No, you study ornamental plants in other chapter, in ecological chapters. B, hallucinogenic plant, of course correct. Immunomodulator plant. What do you mean by immunomodulator? Which alters the response of the immune system. Fine. And depression plants. What do you mean by depression? That causes sedatives, nothing but depression. Fine. Or depressive plants. Atropa velodoma is a plant which produces chemicals which causes hallucinations. Hence, thereby, it is known as hallucinogenic plant. C. B is the correct answer. Next question. Generally, cannabinoids are taken. They are asking in what way they are taken. Fine. Cannabinoids are taken intravenously. What do you mean by intravenously? It is injected into veins, that is IV. Fine. Intramuscular, that is IM, into the muscles through injection, through syringe. Injection means, don't get confused, through syringes. They are asking through oral route, of course it's correct, and through implants. Fine. Generally, cannabinoids are taken through oral route. What do you mean by oral route? Through mouth. Fine. In the form of powders. Fine. Clear. Cannabinoids are taken in such a way. Fine. I have told you, snuff is taken to nose, and certain drugs are taken through injections and the syringes. So all those things. So here, cannabinoids are generally taken through oral route, that is in the mouth. Certain tobacco products are also taken. Certain people chew, which causes cancer, we are told. Okay, LSD, very easy question. Fine. Lysergic acid diethylamide, LSD. So option A, lauric acid diethylamide, don't get confused. B, lysergic acid diethylamide, clear. Lysergic acid diethylamide, clear. So in B option, he has said dimethyl, don't get confused. Actually, his correct one is lysergic acid diethylamide. So option C is the correct answer. Next questions, fine. Dash is a very effective painkiller and sedative. What do you mean by sedative? That lowers your response of your immune system, feels you dull, fine. Feeling sleepy or drowsiness is what is known as sedative drugs, depressants, like for example heroin is a depressive drug. Fine. Okay, what he's asking is, DASH is a very effective painkiller and sedative used for patients who has undergone surgery so that they can take rest. Such what is given? Mild morphine is given to them. What is given? Morphine is given. So here, very effective painkiller. Of course, the certain laborers will take this in other forms, morphine, because to relieve from body pain. And sedative, they get good sleep also, but it is used in lower doses in medicine also to overcome the post-operative or post-surgery problems and effects. So morphine is given to them. Next one, you all know paracetamol, it's a painkiller. LSD, just now we saw lysergic acid diethylamide, barbiturates, that's all you know. Fine. Next one is known as Datura, is a dash plant. Datura is a what plant? Sedative, B, hallucinogenic, C, excitatory, means which excites you, which stimulates you, which makes you active, hyperactive. D, health tonic, no, can't be, never. So it is hallucinogenic plant. Datura is a hallucinogenic plant, clear. Moving on to next and the last topic most probably. AIDS do not spread by A, sexual contact, B, body fluids, C, physical touch. Do not spread. Do not is the main word over here. Do not spread by physical touch. You can touch, you can handshake, you can hug the AIDS patients. Fine. Okay. So through physical touch, physical contact, AIDS virus, HIV virus won't get transmitted from infected person to normal person. But it get transmitted through all other options, that is A, B and D. That is sexual contact, body fluids and blood transfusion. He is asking not spreaded by physical touch. Next, treatment of AIDS with antiretroviral drug. Antiretroviral drug is not at all effective, fully effective, partially effective, leads to secondary infections. Antiretroviral, against the retroviral activity means it slows down the replicative process of the retrovirus, HIV virus or retrovirus, RNA viruses. They are partially effective because they slows down the replication of this virus. We have told you antiviral, anti-replicating chemicals or certain chemicals which are found present even in human milk and human tears. I told you natural therapy research is going on in Indian Institute of Science regarding this. So that's known as natural therapy, wherein anti-replicating chemicals are taken and they are used to slow down the replicative cycle. So they are known as partially effective. Next one, when plants have hallucinogenic properties are administered in more than required amount, excess amount, more than adequate, more than required, excess amount is taken, clear. So what happens, is asking, fine. When plants having hallucinogenic properties are administered in more than the required amount or frequency, it causes what? A, addiction, B, drug abuse, C, cancer, Fine. And D, both A and B. It causes addiction, of course, correct. And also, it causes drug abuse. What do you mean by drug abuse? Excess or unnecessary use of drugs or chemicals is known as drug abuse. Clear? So, A, addiction also. All these drugs have addiction property. And drug abuse also. What is drug abuse? Not required. Whenever it's not required or more than required, or you become used to that, unless and until you have, you won't feel satisfied or comfortable. Such a use of drugs is known as drug abuse. Next question, barbiturates and benzodiazepines are used clinically, clinical conditions like, so these are the chemicals, very strong chemicals, steroidal chemicals, fine. Where they are used is asking, fine. So cancer and its prevention, A, cancer and its prevention, B, euphoria and sense of well-being, C, depression and insomnia, increasing body strength and vigor. They are used in depression and insomnia, clear? It's a disorder of sleep and nervous system, fine. Insomnia, certain, to some extent, they lose memory also. Insomnia conditions, fine. Next question. Tobacco has been used by humans being for more than dash years. Tobacco has been used more than 400 years. 400 years in our country also. So next is, tobacco contains an alkaloid known as dash. Tobacco contains nicotine. You all know that Nicotiana tobacum is the name, botanical name of the tobacco plant. So thereby it contains a chemical nicotine, hence it is named as Nicotiana tobacum. So tobacco contains an alkaloid known as nicotine. C. Next is, nicotine stimulates which gland primarily? Basically, nicotine stimulates which gland? He's asking. He has given salivary glands, of course, no. Pancreas, no. Spleen, no. Salivary and pancreas, they get stimulated only during digestion, fine. Salivary amylase, pancreatic, fine, juice. So spleen, no way. Spleen is connected with nicotine, clear. Next one, adrenal gland. What gland? Adrenal gland, fine. D, option, adrenal gland, because nicotine acts as a stimulant. Nicotine acts as a stimulant, so thereby it releases more of adrenal hormones like adrenocorticoids, adrenal mineraloids. They are very beneficial. What it excess secretion of adrenaline, thereby this more supply of blood and people feel like active, when they feel like comfortable or hyperactive, because adrenaline is more secreted from the adrenal gland, but basically adrenaline, emergency situation, emergency hormone, which is more secreted from adrenal gland, thereby it acts as a stimulant, nicotine, which is found present in tobacco plant, Nicotiana tobacco. Next one, what is the effect of nicotine? Again, almost same. What is the effect of nicotine? It relieves stress and anxiety. It gives a sense of well-being and happiness. It raises blood pressure and heart rate. Of course, correct. When adrenaline is more released in the body, it of course increases. He says raises. C option is correct. It raises blood pressure, of course, BP, and also heart rate. Heartbeat will also be increased because adrenaline hormone is released into the bloodstream. Thereby, it increases the blood supply. Just now I told you. Next one. Smoking increases the content of which compound in the blood? Clear? He has given 3-4 chemical compounds: carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, hydrogen peroxide, and H2O2, hydrogen peroxide, H2CO3, hydrogen carbonide, most probably. Okay, it increases what? Carbon monoxide in the blood. Carbon monoxide, CO, is increased more than the required. So it is, which is very toxic to our cells and blood also, because more carbon monoxide is increases, our hemoglobin turns to carboxyhemoglobin, that results in the shrinkage of the hemoglobin, that leads to suffocation or the toxic chemical for the cells. There are chances that cells will also die. So carbon monoxide amount will increase in the body when smoking is done. So that's why it has to be stopped, and our smoking also causes cancers. Next question. Adolescent period ranges. Very easy question. Adolescent, fine. From 12 to 18, that is from, we have told teenagers. Generally, we have told teenage. Adolescent period ranges from 12 to 18 years. Next. Adolescence is a bridge linking dash and dash. Teenage and marriage, of course, no. Childhood and adulthood, right, correct. Teenage and adulthood, birth and death. Adolescence, it's a link between, bridge linking what? Childhood. You'll be crossing childhood and entering into adulthood. Such a complex, fine, is age is what is known as adolescence age, where usually puberty and maturation also takes place. Fine. Next questions. Dash is a psychological attachment to certain effects like euphoria associated with drugs and alcohol. is asking. Dash is psychological attachment. Fine. You get psychologically attached to that, without which you feel, you don't feel comfortable. Fine. So such a attachment, fine, getting used to it, fine, habituated to it, becoming habituated to that, such a concept is what is known as addiction. So B is addiction. He says A, hallucinations, B, addiction, C, delusions, and D, illusions. Opposite of illusion is delusions. You all know the terminology. Next, 203rd question. If regular doses of drugs or alcohol is abruptly discontinued, abruptly, immediately discontinues, it causes, what it causes? So we have told you that slowly, how, like, how it has been started, in a similar manner it has to be stopped, because people will be used to it, systems will be used to it. So slowly it has to be stopped. You have to overcome those habits like alcohol, drug, and even smoking also. So if you abruptly, suddenly, fine, randomly, if you stop, what happens? You come across certain symptoms known as withdrawal symptoms, what collectively is known as withdrawal syndrome, which includes shivering, vomiting, nausea, perspiration, there is nothing but sweating, feeling uncomfortableness, breathlessness, all these things happen, all together known as withdrawal symptoms, and they are together known as withdrawal syndrome. He says A, hallucination, B, withdrawal symptoms, C, diversion to criminal activities, severe depression. Severe depression may also occur, but it's a part of the withdrawal syndrome or symptoms. So option B is the most appropriate answer over here. Next question. Death in case of overdose of drug occurs due to respiratory failure, correct. Heart failure also correct. Cerebral hemorrhage also correct. Overdoses of excess consumption of steroidal drugs or drugs leads to respiratory problem also. They choke the lung, thereby alveoli stops functioning. Heart failure also, fine, because of the excess of blood pressure, fine, heart cannot cooperate with the respiratory rate and circulatory rate. Heart failure also takes place. That all leads to cerebral hemorrhage due to abruptly supply of the blood in narrow veins, smaller veins in the brain, fine, that leads to cerebral hemorrhage, clotting of the internal clotting of the blood. So all these occurs in overdoses. That's how people enter into coma. Comma, 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 full stop. There is nothing but comma, coma to death. I have told you this. Next, drug abusers, the people who uses excess of drugs or chemicals without even there is a requirement or need, are known as drug abusers, can suffer from infections like hepatitis, A, hepatitis, B, depression, C, euphoria, D, cirrhosis. Fine. A, hepatitis, because hepatitis, you know, liver is a detoxifying organ, multifunctional organ. It helps in detoxification. When excess drugs are taken, infection to liver takes place. Of course it is known as hepatitis is caused by viruses, but when the immune system goes down, when liver becomes weak, chances that are there that these viruses will attack the liver, leads to hepatitis. Fine. Hepatitis is the infection of the liver by viruses, whereas jaundice is a disorder of the liver that we have studied in case of disorders of digestive system, hemolytic jaundice, obstructive jaundice we have seen, hemolytic jaundice we have seen, different types of jaundice, that is the disorders of the digestive system, whereas hepatitis is a different, fine. Itis, I have told you, it is an infection. Hepatitis is an infection of the liver due to viruses, it is caused, fine. Whereas cirrhosis also, you might have heard one word known as liver cirrhosis, where the liver cells or hepatocytes will slowly dry and die and stop functioning, is known as cirrhosis. Euphoria and depression, you know the terminology. Next question. Chronic alcoholism, chronic, severe, prolonged, serious, from many years together. Chronic alcoholism damages which vital organ? Vital, very important organs of the body. Fine. A, heart, B, kidney, C, liver, D, brain, which is again multifunctional liver. When liver is damaged, slowly heart or kidneys will also get infected. So multifunctional organ, very important organ, liver will get damaged. Chronic alcoholism, because it has to perform detoxification every day, and excess of consumption of alcohol damages the hepatocytes, liver cells, that also leads to liver cancer, liver cirrhosis, all those things. Though regeneration property is there, but when it is excess, you can't overcome. Next. Generally, sportsmen abuse which categories of drugs? Fine. Which categories of drugs? Immunomodulators? No. Fine. Anabolic steroids, of course, correct. Cannabinoids, fine. Protein painkillers. Anabolic, because they need more energy, fine. So and they take anabolic steroids so that to stimulate their energy, fine, their level. So sports people, athletics, generally they take anabolic steroids. Next one. the 208th question. Which categories of drugs are used by sportsmen? Just now, certain hormones or force they use, like adrenaline. Fine. Hormones also used. Anabolic steroids. Just now we learned in the above question. Diuretics also they used. Fine. Clear. Clear. Diuretics, so that this is a hormones effect will be there in the body, and this chemical should be eliminated out of the body through urine. So they also take along with the diuretic also say, that's why urine test is done to check whether these sports people or athletics have taken drugs. Urine test is done, blood test is also done, and moreover urine test is also done, because so that's why to overcome that they take, what do you mean by diuretic? That increases the flow of urine is known as diuretic. Fine. Such chemicals are known as diuretic. Next one, liver damage is termed as leaching. You know what is leaching? It is nothing but of the therapy by using urinaria, leach therapy. B, cirrhosis, of course this is correct. Aplasia, no. Hemorrhage, no. Cirrhosis, liver cirrhosis, just now I mentioned over here when we were discussing about this question. Last question of this chapter. If females are administered anabolic steroids, clear, anabolic steroids, if females are administered, I mean given to females, which of the following symptoms are observed? Abnormal menstruation, correct, because it changes the hormone. Hormonal imbalance takes place that indirectly leads to abnormal cycle. Then excessive hair growth, of course, correct. Excessive body hair growth, enlargement of clitoris, that also takes place. So hence the steroids should not be taken, particularly anabolic steroids should not be taken by females, because they have many side effects and adverse effects. So the answer is all of these here. So here we complete the NEET of 8th chapter. Apart from these questions, 210 questions have been discussed. Very important chapter. Very interesting chapter as well, medical oriented chapter. And moreover, apart from this, if you have any doubts along with the question and options, you can WhatsApp me, you can call me up and get it clarified, your doubts. Keep studying. God bless you. Good luck. Take care.